Okay, let's do some math for fun. Last time we solved the equation x to the x power equals 2 by using the Lambert W function. If you guys haven't seen that video, be sure you guys go check that out. Today, let's talk about the equation x to the x to the x equals 2. Unfortunately though, I don't know how to use the Lambert W function to solve this, nor I don't even know if it's even possible to solve this by using the Lambert W function. So leave a comment down below and let me know what you think. If it works or not. If it does, show me your solution. I appreciate it. Thank you. Yeah. But it's okay. Even though I'm not going to use Lambert, I have Newton to back me up. So I will show you guys how we can use the Newton's method to get a really good approximation for the solution to this equation. And remember, the Newton's method is to find the zero of a function. So perhaps we can look at this equation and minus 2 on both sides, we get x to the x to the x minus 2 equals 0. And then we can just take this part to be my function. So I'll write this down. I will just say let f of x be x to the x to the x minus 2 right here. And notice this right here is continuous. And we can also see that we do have a 0 between 1 and 2. Why? Because if x is 1, 1 to the 1 to the 1 minus 2 is just negative 1. And when x is 2, 2 to the 2 to the 2, you do 2 to the 2 first, which is 4, and then you do 2 to the 4, which is 16, and then minus 2 is 14, positive, right? So by intermediate value theorem, this right here, it does have a solution in between of 1 and 2. And in order for us to use the Newton's method, we need the derivative of this function. Yes, I have a video on the derivative of this triple S function. So go check that out as well. I will just write down the answer for you guys though. The derivative right here is, I just have to differentiate this because the derivative of negative 2 is just 0. So we get x to the x times x to the x to the x. And 1 over x, okay? And we add natural log of x. And we add natural log of x to the second power. Yeah, so it's all this times all that. This right here can be a really cool calculus one question. Yeah. Anyway, so this right here is the derivative. And now, to use the Newton's method, I have to pick a beginning value. I will just say I want to pick x1 to be 1. All right? And then, of course, by Newton, I'll write down the formula for you guys. And yes, I have a video on how we derive the formula. So go check that out if you haven't seen it already. I will tell you that xn plus 1, meaning the next x value, that should give us a really good 0, right? That's the approximation should be better and better. Hopefully that's the case. Sometimes it may not work, but in this case it works. So let me just tell you that. Anyway, xn plus 1 is equal to xn, meaning the previous x value, and then we minus the value of the function at the previous x value divided by the derivative at xn. So that's pretty much the idea. And we are going to start at 1. So let me go over this with you guys. So let me write down. The first one is just, of course, 1. So that's a good start, huh? Next, x2. What we do is look at the previous x value, put it here, which is 1. And then minus, I have to put in 1 right here, namely f of 1. So that means I put on 1 right here. And then divided by f prime of 1, meaning I put on 1 right here. This is not that bad. This is exactly 2. So that's good. Right, it's just 1 less than pi. Anyway, so that's pretty much the idea. And we'll just keep going. Because you can see this is clearly not the answer, and just keep going. So you do x3, and this is what you do is you put in the previous x value. I'll just put on x2 or maybe this 2, and then minus. I'll just show you guys the work one more time like this, and then f prime of 2 like that, and then use a computer, Excel or Python. Well, I don't know what language that you guys use for the computer. Programs, all that stuff, but I will tell you I'm using GeoGebra, and the answer that I can see is this is approximately 1.86929, right? So I have this right here, okay? And then we continue, and now we are making a good progress. 147, this match, right? So we can kind of see maybe these right here are the, you know, the first three digits of the solution to that. Let's just do it again. X9 is approximately 1.46. So 1.476684. And then 3374, like this. Yep. And as you can see, 1 match, 4 match, and 7668. Ah, this don't match, right? So that's pretty good because you can see that we have a pretty good approximation already. Perhaps you can do it one more time. Let's stop it at the X10, the perfect 10. So we get this right here, approximately 1.47668. In fact, you actually get exactly the same once you have X9 and X10. So you have all this, 4, 3, 3, 7, 4. I'm not kidding, this and that are exactly the same, right? For the first so many digits. Of course, maybe if you have more digits, maybe the digits will be off here and here, but we don't know. So I think I can stop right here. This will be my approximation to the zero of that equation. Well, that equation. Well, that. So in another way, if you take this, raise to itself, and you do that power first, and then you do this to that power, you will get 2, or maybe almost 2, right? So this is the Newton's method. In fact, this is a secret weapon. Whenever you are trying to solve an equation, as long as you can do the derivative, as long as it has the derivative, as long as the derivative at your initial value is not zero, as long as you see this right here, it's making good progress. It's good. Anyway, hopefully you guys all like this. And if you guys are new to my channel, please subscribe. And you guys will find more interesting math videos on my channel. Thank you guys so much. That's it.